Let's go. It's the most beautiful time of the year. Lights fill the streets, spreading so much cheer. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. I don't wanna miss out on the holiday. Hey guys, it's Brianna, and welcome to Beauty by Bree. So today we are going to be doing something we have never done on this channel before, and that is glam kitchen, okay? Because there's no reason for anyone to have this much makeup on or heels while they cook. But, you know, it's just gonna be something that we try out today because I am not domestic, nor am I usually very festive. So, we are going to try to do something different today. This is a very, very simple and easy Christmas recipe. Okay, so we're gonna make festive Oreo balls. So, the first step is get you some Oreos. We got family size, okay? So, let's open these babies up. All right. And we're gonna go ahead and crush these babies up. So you can either do the barbaric way of crushing with your fingers, and we're gonna watch. Oh shoot, my acrylic nails get very messy doing this. So we're gonna crush them up like this. Very, very nicely, okay? Crush, 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 crush. Okay, and we're gonna use probably almost the whole pack. Okay, so after we've crushed up some of the Oreos, we're only gonna do like half of them to start, okay? And next you get some softened cream cheese. We just got the cheap, great value kind. Very, very inexpensive. And we're gonna go ahead and put this in there. All of it, all the cream cheese. It's just one pack. It's fat-free too, so hey, we're watching our weight while we make this dessert. And then this is the best part, which is mixing the Oreo crumbles with the what are we using? Cream cheese. So we're just gonna mix, and then we're gonna crunch. We only use about one layer of Oreo, so we're gonna make sure that we use the majority of the pack. So for the holidays, I know some people get a little emotional when they have to go home. Sometimes you can have family dysfunction, so making Oreo balls is a great way to get rid of all that anger. Oh yeah, nice and crushed up. Okay, now we have some very crumbled up Oreos thanks to our mental health. And we're gonna mix it all up. It looks so good. Looks so yummy. I love the smell of Oreos. It smells so good. And we're just gonna keep mixing and mixing until it's all ready to go. Looks like we have something that will spice this up. What could it be? Smirnoff peppermint twist vodka. Just what we need to spice these Oreo balls up now that I'm legally 21. So we're gonna take our shot glass and we're just gonna put a little bit. We're not trying to, you know, these aren't bourbon balls, okay? They're vodka Oreo balls. And this is just gonna give it, we're gonna give it just
two shots of vodka.
And this is just gonna give it a nice minty taste. If you like thin mints, this is gonna be good for you. If you don't, then don't add any, you don't have to. This is just to help spice it up. It's also gonna help us mix up our mix. So now that it's added, we're just gonna continue to mix. This is great. Smells even better now. This is like so minty. We have been using this even to put in our hot chocolate, which is also a great holiday treat. So we're just gonna add a couple more Oreos, and we're gonna use the crunching method this time and mix with our bag method, because it's good to have different kinds of treat layers. You want some of them to be crunchy and some of them to be very fine. And as you can see, we're just adding a lot more. And this is not nearly crunched up enough. So we're gonna keep mixing, get it good in the mix. All right, I am so tired of these heels. So we're gonna get them off, because I'm over it. Okay, don't get my toes, because they're not painted. Next, we're gonna take all this yummy, yummy stuff that's nice and ready to go, our Oreo mix, and we're gonna put them into balls. So this is the part where it gets kind of messy. You just take your hand and you roll them up into little balls and you place them onto your cookie sheet. One by one, you scoop them out and you roll it up and you place it onto your cookie sheet. They can be big, they can be small. It really doesn't matter. They're just like snowflakes, they're all different. It's the most beautiful time of the year. Lights fill the streets, spreading so much cheer. I should be playing in the winter snow, but I'ma be under the mistletoe. I don't wanna miss out on the. A little messy, but it's the only way to do it that I know of. You could probably wear gloves if you wanted to. But now you just wash all of that off, all that. Okay, so now the bowl is empty. We have made our tray of Oreo balls, and we're gonna go ahead and put them in the fridge so they can cool. I recommend leaving them in there for a couple hours. So we're just gonna go ahead and put these in the fridge. Come with me to the fridge. So, for step three, I think, wait, what step are we on? One was crushing, two was cream cheese, three was rolling in a ball. So we're on step four. Step four, it's time for a pose break. Come on, Laura. My anaconda don't, my anaconda don't, my anaconda don't want none unless you got buns, hun. All right, so I'm tired of this hat because I'm getting like super sweaty and I don't think it looks that good, so probably don't ever shake your hair out around food. Probably not the most sanitary thing to do, but it's time for step five, which is the almond bark. So these Oreos, we have had them in the fridge for like 3 hours now, so they're nice and cold and ready to go. They're not mushy anymore, they're not leaving any residue on my hand. So now we're gonna use this bark. Now, I have never done anything like this before in my life. So, I can't break it. So that's good. So we're just gonna put it in there, okay? Next, we're gonna put it in the microwave and see how long it takes for this stuff to melt. So it magically became broken, and now it's time for it to go into the microwave.
You're domestic.
I'm so domestic. Okay, let's do 25 seconds. No, 30.
Probably a lot longer than that.
Okay, let's do 2 minutes in the microwave. Okay, so it is ready. You can see that it's nice and melted, okay? So, next we're gonna whisk it up. Whisking, whisking, whisking. This is a skill that many women have. They're great at whisking. All right, so I've never done this before, ever. So we're gonna try a couple techniques. So I think dipping it would be nice. I think that would cover it up really nicely. The nice dipping method, and then we can put it back on there. Or we can try a drizzle method of like drizzling it and kind of covering it up. I don't know, I think dipping is probably the best. And my hands are already messy. So I feel like, I feel like I know exactly what I'm doing. So we're gonna do a drizzle dip method. And that is how we're gonna make these delicious Oreo bags. Don't these look so yummy? We're gonna use some sprinkles. And I wanted to get red or green for Christmas to be a little bit more festive, but they were out because I feel like maybe everyone's doing Oreo balls right now. And that's probably why they were out of red and green sprinkles. And so we're gonna use gold. And we're just gonna sprinkle these up. It looks like some of them have already hardened. So the sprinkles aren't gonna go on all of them as well as I had expected, because the bark is already dried on some of them, but I think they look really pretty. Like, hire me for your wedding, okay? Hire me for your wedding, for your desserts. So now they're ready to go, and I'm just gonna put them in the freezer just for a little bit, just to kind of to chill them up, so they'll be ready to eat. So you guys remember, to be you, be beautiful. Beauty by Bree. Thanks for joining me today, guys, and happy holidays. It's so good.
That is really good.
Crack.